With a much-needed bye week behind them, the Rebels prepare to pack their bags for a road trip to Little Rock to take on the resurgent Hogs from Arkansas.
Good to see you guys. Thanks for being here. We're very excited about coming off the open week and trying to get ready to go play Arkansas in Little Rock, which is exciting to get back on the field. I know that's a place that's very difficult to play, and they've been very, very good there. And they're playing with great confidence right now. So coming off two wins, to which both sides of their ball and special teams have played extremely well. Obviously, they have NFL caliber players at certain positions there that are always grab your attention when you're watching the film. So I think with the last couple of weeks and the confidence that they've gained and the job that Coach Smith and his staff have done of rallying them amid some difficult times at the start of their season, I think speaks volumes for their character and the way they want to finish the year. So I'm expecting to have a great test and a great battle there.
See DT on the floor down there? That man must really be working hard, man. Sleeping in front of his locker, in the locker room. I give it to him. He do be working hard, though. He be working hard, man. So he deserves a little nap before we go out to practice, you know. Even though he ain't practicing yet, he deserves it. I believe a man work hard 24/7.
The season, Ole Miss football is brought to you in part by FedEx, proud supporter of the Ole Miss Rebels. FedEx, solutions that matter. Regions Bank, proud sponsor of the SEC. One Mississippi, your health insurance marketplace. One Mississippi, count me in. CSpire, personalized wireless. Allstate, are you in good hands? The Mississippi Department of Transportation, make Mississippi proud. Pick it up, Mississippi. And by Kroger. Visit the MillionMillsChallenge.com or text HUNGER to 66856 to help feed the hungry in our state.
How am I supposed to sell you guys as the most dangerous band in the world when you're seen schlepping golf clubs through the airport?
But we love golf.
No. As far as your fans know, you are only capable of hate.
I don't hate golf.
From now on, I'm shipping your clubs with FedEx right to the golf course. Now learn how to trash a hotel room.
Let me get some water for those flowers.
Let FedEx Office pack and ship your clubs, luggage, and more. FedEx, solutions that matter.
Banking is easier with Regions Checking because our text and mobile banking lets you manage your accounts anytime on any device. You can get alerts, transfer funds, and with mobile banking, pay bills from anywhere. So now, whether you're here, here, or here, you can always be here with a simpler way to bank and a simpler way to get where you want to go. I know that guy. Weird.
Hi, I'm Mississippi Insurance Commissioner Mike Cheney. I believe that competition brings out the best in all of us, whether on the gridiron or in the marketplace. I also believe in a competitive free market solution for providing health insurance products to individuals and business owners in our state. That solution is One Mississippi, your health insurance marketplace.
For more information, visit onemississippi.com or contact your local insurance agent.
One Mississippi, count me in.
Sure, 4G networks are powerful. They get stuff to you fast. But is that all there is to them? There's only one 4G network that first gets to know you and then brings you things that are right for you. Fast. For a faster you, join CSpire. Personalized wireless.
With our no-work switch kit, it's even easier to switch to CSpire.
Time to work, baby.
October in Mississippi. The crisp fall afternoons paint the perfect backdrop as the Rebel football squad hit the practice fields in anticipation of their next SEC showdown.
We got some nice weather, baby. Got some nice weather. I think about that jump shot I saw you with on Saturday. That thing was nasty. You missed the jump shot. And it handled. Then he busted my lip trying to play defense. Lap. Ready to go? That's it. Get your feet a little bit closer. You got your feet about that wide right there. You can't adjust at all. Nice. Good. Bring it back. Bring it back. Bring it back. Good. Here we go. Lap. Lap. Ready to go? Good. Nice. Nice. Nice.
When the season began, junior running back Jeff Scott was battling a lingering injury, limiting his playing time. But as his body healed, his minutes increased, along with his stats. The Florida native recalls the long road to becoming a starting tailback in the SEC.
Well, I've been to three different high schools, and the second school I ended up transferring was Archbishop Carroll. And they gave me an opportunity to play running back. It was a Division II, 2A school. And after I rushed for like 1,400 yards my junior year, I started getting letters. And Florida International was my first offer. And then I ended up getting an offer from Ole Miss. I was verbal committed to FIU. I wanted to stay close to home. But after a while, whatever, I just thought about it, and I was like, everybody already was saying that I'm undersized and I'm not really playing against anybody, and I wanted to prove to myself that I can play with the best, so I chose to come to the University of Mississippi. When I first got out here, I was kind of confused or whatever. It was kind of hard to adjust just being from home or whatever. I've never been so far from Miami. Leaving out of the state, the farthest I think I went was, Georgia. But, I think it was pretty tough. But I think, going to my third year, I think I've handled it pretty well. Every semester that's been passing by, I've been getting a lot better grades-wise, academically, and I'm doing a lot much better off the field. And, I think everything's going good right about now.
I think the biggest thing for Jeff just since his first time he stepped on campus here at Ole Miss, is adjusting to the speed of the game, and believe it or not, some guys that are maybe just as fast as him and maybe bigger. And I think right now he's a seasoned vet. He's had three seasons now in the SEC. He's a guy that's maturing, and he's learning and becoming a better player each and every time he steps on the field. And like we always thought in the beginning, the sky's the limit with him if he can get it all put together into having some positive energy going the right way, and he's doing that right now.
The roommate, me and Jeff been roommate for, 2.5 years now. That's kind of like my little brother, That's how I look at him, and, he got my back, I got his back. He's real humble at times, but he do has that short man syndrome where he could just catch a fit at times too, but at the same time, he just a just a cool kid, kind-hearted, and I just love to play football.
I read about it all the time. Oh, Jeff Scott, he's not durable or whatever. He's too small or whatever. He's fast off the edge, but he can't run between the tackles. Every time I'm working out and I'm training, I think about that, and I think about my family. And, I just use it as motivation. I just go out there and I play with that chip on my shoulder to prove everybody wrong that I can be durable to carry the ball 20 or 25 times a game if I had to for my team to win. When the big players come or whatever, I'm not really surprised because, it's been something I've been doing all my life or whatever, but and I've always been the type of player, every time I touch the ball, I play with that chip on my shoulder. Every time I touch it, I just try to score a touchdown or whatever. But, my running back coach, which I've been with for 3 years, Coach Derek Nix, he talked to me and he was like, you can't always look for the big runs. You have to take whatever you can and just be patient and the big run to come.
He has H.R. Greer in as a H-back. There's the handoff sweeping to the right, to the 20, the 25, down the sidelines. He may go. Here goes Scott. He's to the 50, to the 45, to the 40, to the 30. Auburn's got an angle to the 20. They are not going to catch him. He's to the 5. Touchdown, Ole Miss. Jeff Scott takes it to the house.
David, we've been looking for some playmakers. Jeff Scott on a simple speed sweep comes back to the wide side of the field. A great block outside, and all of a sudden, Jeff Scott goes the distance.
I can remember him going down that sideline with his head up in the air and those feet flying from back behind him and outrunning everybody down the field. And I can remember him being so excited in the end zone and running right down to that student section And it was a big moment for him in his career. And I think it was really the opportunity for him to realize that he could really play on this level.
Once I scored that long touchdown, I mean, I couldn't believe it. To be honest, once I saw Brandon Bolden made his block and I cut it off him and got upfield, and I was like, no way. Like, I got a chance of scoring this. And as I'm running, I'm thinking this or whatever. And I mean, I just gave it all I got. I just opened up. Once I got in the end zone or whatever, I think Melvin Harris ended up tackling me in the end zone. And I mean, once I got up, Bobby Massey, he lifted me up in the air or whatever, and the whole crowd was just going crazy. And I mean, that's one of my best experiences I ever had in my life. It was the best feeling ever.
What's going on, man?
How's it going, man?
Going great. Just got done eating. That always makes me happy.
That's your favorite part of the trip?
The trip goes to game, and it goes to food. That's it. I love the food, man. Eat like a king when you go on road trips.
Feel good. I prefer the early morning game because, you know, wake up with all the energy, and you don't have to sit around all day and wait for everyone to start, you know, moving around. You just go out there, get a win, and come back home.
Good.
Going good. Ready to get this game started.
Yes, sir.
Long week.
Yep.
You like morning games?
Yeah, I like morning games. I don't like the hotel that much.
No.
I like to get the game started, get it out of the way.
Yeah, get you started early, though.
I'm your lucky team, Flag. We've gone through 14 seasons together, but in Flag years, I'm like 130. Now, I'm just holding on by a thread.
If you've got cut rate insurance, you could be dealing with this mess yourself.
So get Allstate, where agents keep you protected from mayhem like me.
Mayhem is everywhere. So get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
What?
Nobody likes it when people litter. I'm Transportation Commissioner Mike Taggart, reminding you to keep it clean, Mississippi, and put trash where it belongs.
Hello, Rebel fans. Ole Miss has teamed up with Mississippi State and Memphis this season to help Kroger fight hunger. Join us as we fight hunger together in the Million Meals Challenge. You can make a difference by picking up items at your local Kroger store for donation, making a monetary donation online at themillionmealschallenge.com, or text HUNGER to 66856. Donate to win the cup. Donate to feed the hungry. Donate for a chance to win Ole Miss gear and prizes. For more information, visit themillionmealschallenge.com and help make a difference.
I am a rebel.
I am a wellness rebel.
I am a research rebel.
A business rebel.
I'm a creative rebel.
A visionary.
A leader.
I am an innovator.
I am a rebel.
I am a rebel.
I am a rebel. I am an Ole Miss rebel.
Making a difference in the world.
Little Rock, Arkansas, home to War Memorial Stadium. And on this day, it is a Southeastern Conference battlefield. A win for either team would be a huge step toward bowl eligibility, raising the stakes for everyone involved.
Who's freeze? We're going to freeze Ole Miss in their place. It's over. It's over. Ole Miss is done. Go home.
Woo! Pizza! Yeah, go
home.
Go Miss
is
going down.
Oh, yeah, man. Got to. The last week we can represent for the women, man. That's good, though. With breast cancer awareness, man. The last week, man. I don't, but I still, you know, my dad died from cancer, period. So, I just represent, you know, whenever I can, man. Really.
We said all along,
who will be the two this week. They now had to decide how much further they wanted to take it, and they sent 12 guys in there, yeah. And two came back and said, hey, let me tell you something. It's going to be tough. It ain't going to be easy. They're bigger. They're stronger. Maybe a little faster. It ain't going to be easy, but we can take them. In other words, the way that we need to put it is, man, which one of you two will have enough courage to say, hey, let's walk down this ramp, let's lock this gate behind us, and let's go pick a fight with some hoes!
The Rebel defense knew they would have their hands full all day, as Arkansas boasts one of the top quarterbacks in the country, and a stable of shifty running backs. The potent offense made its way to the Rebel 10-yard line, and were knocking at the door.
Gun formation here for Tyler Wilson. There's the snap. In the pocket, zips it near side, out route, caught, tackle to the 5-yard line, shy of the first down. Snap back and down, and there's the field goal effort, and it is going to be good. So Arkansas held to a field goal, but the Hogs take the early lead, 3-0 as they strike first.
On the next Arkansas possession, quarterback Tyler Wilson guided the Hogs swiftly down the field.
Toward the left, play action. Wilson wants to throw in the pocket. He's hit as he leaves it down the middle of the field. It's caught. Touchdown, Arkansas. Chris Gregg, he laid it in there, dropped it in the bucket. Wilson got it.
Third down. I want y'all to look at each other and challenge each other on third down that we get off the field. You got me?
Playing on the road in the SEC is always a difficult task. But playing from behind is even more so. For the Rebel offense, a response was critical.
Here's a pass, zipped near side, diving forward on a back shoulder throw there at the 11 was Vincent Sanders near silence. What a great throw and catch. Wallace throws to the end zone to Sanders. He catches it near corner for the touchdown, and the Rebels are on the board.
Well, we were like on the 4-yard line, if I'm mistaken, and the play came in, and I knew I had a fade ball, and I thought to myself, okay, on the receiver on this side, press coverage. I think Bo gonna give me a shot. So once I lined up, I saw the DB like kind of play outside. So I knew I had to work him a little bit and snap with the ball. I gave him some at the line and I got close to him. And I looked back at Bo and he threw the back shoulder and I made the catch.
Good job. Hey, good job. I told you, boy. Good job.
Hey, y'all see what happens when we get pressure on? We're gonna get y'all picked. Y'all keep bringing it to him.
With the Rebels now on the board, though momentum was evening between the two teams. Safety Charles Sawyer would do his part to swing the momentum even further toward the Rebels.
From the 40, play action, back to throw. Wilson deep over the middle, one on one to pass. This time is picked off and falling to the ground is Charles Sawyer. Wallace. Puts Mosley in motion to give him three receivers left. Now fires it out to Mackey. He's got a couple of blockers ahead. Gets to the 20, to the 25. Lowers his head, runs into traffic, and dropped at the 32, 33-yard line. Snap quickly. Wallace fakes, now throws, and it's going to be picked off as he was hit in the backfield, and Arkansas will catch the pass on the 35-yard line. Intended for Dante Moncrief, and Rasner stepped right in front of him for the pick.
Thrown back into action, the Rebel defense would respond. After holding the Razorbacks on downs, Charles Sawyer would make his presence known once again.
Snap, there it is, and he'll kick it. Blocked by the Rebels! It's Charles Sawyer, he scoops, and Sawyer's headed toward the end zone, but tripped up from behind at the 22-yard line. Charles Sawyer with the block and the scoop, and what a huge play on special teams.
After I blocked it, I saw the ball from the side of my helmet. Basically go to the right, but I don't know if it went behind me or in front of me. So I would look downfield and it was on the ground. So I ran and tried to scoop it as fast as I could. You know, once you get the ball, you're just trying to score. And you know, once you have one man to beat and he got you by your shoelaces, it's like, I almost had it. But I mean, it was a good experience.
That's my dog! That's my dog! Hey,
Following the turnover, the Rebel offense would move quickly into the red zone, and quarterback Barry Brunetti would get the call.
It's overloaded toward the left. Brunetti fakes, keeps, takes it in. Touchdown, Ole Miss. And the Rebels have taken a lead over the Razorbacks.
Oh, it was a straight run. But mostly before, like right when Coach called the play, I mean, gave me the play to run it and go out there and tell the line, I automatically knew in my head it was going to be a touchdown. I just had to just catch the snap, and I knew it was going to be a touchdown. And I kind of just went off the block of Jamal, and wherever he pinned the guy at, that's where I was going to go the other way. So he blocked him outside, and I went inside of him. And like I said, like I told Jamal after the play, that was his touchdown because I don't get that touchdown without his block.
As the half drew near to a close, both offenses were hitting their stride. Arkansas would score again as Wilson found his receiver to take back the lead, leaving the Rebel offense 1 minute, 21 seconds to respond before the half.
Sorry, hey, forget about it now. Hey, we just gotta go play. They're not better than us. We just gotta eliminate minimum speed.
Wallace steps up in the pocket, wanting to throw. He's got his man Mackey down the sidelines, catches it, and out of bounds. Now Scott comes in motion back to him. There's the snap, the handoff to Scott, sweeping right. He's headed to the end zone. Touchdown, Ole Miss.
Good job, The
opening quarter of the second half would be a defensive battle, with neither offense making strides.
Hey, that boy playing. That young man can play football.
Wilson in the gun formation. There's the snap. Only a three-man rush. Wilson looking to throw. Being chased. He's hit. He's sacked back at the 39-yard line by C.J. Johnson.
I was just thinking, man, we need this. We need to get off the field right here on third down. And I was kidding the ball. I had great get off. And I just beat the tackle. I got him on the ground, and I got up to throw the land shark. And the guy pushed me down. He was talking trash the whole game, and I just told him, look, I'm gonna whoop you for 60 minutes, so you have to be ready. And I'm gonna run around you, I'm gonna run through you, I'm gonna run inside you, I'm gonna do all that. And he was telling me how he was an NFL caliber guy, and it kind of motivated me and made me want to just go out and just dominate him for 60 minutes.
The first score of the half would be set up by the opportunistic Rebel defense.
Snap, four-man rush. Wilson has time in the pocket, throws over the middle. It's picked off at midfield. There's a flag in the backfield. The Rebels get the interception as Denzel Kimdichie. He comes back to the 30, hit from behind to the 25-20, still on his feet. The young man is fighting like a mad dog. He's all the way down the 18-yard line.
It was third and two, and with the condensed twins receivers, and I dropped back, and I sunk, and I kind of baited the quarterback to make it seem like one of the receivers were open. And then I broke on a pass and just try to get as many yards as possible.
A spectacular catch by Randall Mackey went unrewarded as he was just short of the first down marker, which would bring on Bryson Rose.
Do not let your mind go relax. Stay focused, we gotta go back to work.
Deep into the fourth quarter, the Arkansas offense would rely heavily on running back Dennis Johnson. With the game tied, the Rebel offense had just over 2 minutes to regain the lead and secure an SEC road win.
Here they come. There's the throw over the middle. It's caught. First down by Jeff Scott as he gets to midfield and then to the 48. Just hit him on a quick hitter. There's the throw out to Mackey. Mackey gets a good block, heads to the sidelines, 35, cuts it back into the 30 and down at the 27. There's the snap. He hands it off to Scott, fakes it, keeps it straight ahead. Wallace to the 20, to the 15. He's down to the 14-yard line. And the Rebels with 15 seconds left to win the game. 3 seconds left. Can Rose do it? 27-27 score. Waiting for the snap. There it is. It's down. The kick is on its way. It definitely has the distance, and it is good! And the Ole Miss Rebels have whipped Arkansas 30-27 here in Little Rock.
Well, after the game, everyone was just so happy. I remember after the kick, people started surrounding me, you know, started, you know, beating me, and, you know, it was awesome to be part of that. And then we went in the locker room, and everyone was just smiling and just thrilled. Everyone was taking Gatorade and throwing it in the air and celebrating. And, you know, it was awesome to be part of that and share it with my teammates. So I'm really thrilled.
What?
Nobody likes it when people litter. I'm Transportation Commissioner Dick Hall reminding you, keep it clean, Mississippi, and let's put trash where it belongs.
I'm a streaker. I'm 300 pounds, painted blue, and apart from the cleats, I'm completely naked.
Go State!
Oops. And if you've got cut rate insurance, they might not pay for this. So get Allstate. Mm. You can save cash and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Mayhem is everywhere. So get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Bob? Oh, hey, Alex. Just picking up some brochures, posters, copies of my acceptance speech.
Great. It's always good to have a backup plan in case I get hit by a meteor.
Wow, your hair looks great. Didn't realize they did Photoshop here.
Hey, good call on those mugs. Can't let them see what you're drinking.
You know, I'm glad we're both running a nice, clean race. No need to get nasty.
Here's your honk if you had an affair with Taylor yard sign.
Looks good.
FedEx Office.
I am a rebel.
I am a wellness rebel. I am a research rebel.
A business rebel.
I'm a creative rebel.
A visionary.
A leader.
I am an innovator.
I am a rebel.
I am a rebel.
I am a rebel. I am an Ole Miss rebel.
Making a difference in the world.
Regardless of what's going on with them, they're a good football team. Yep. And man, you found a way to get you another SEC win.